In today's video, I'm gonna show you this painting. YouTubers, YouTubers, welcome back to another painting session. This is me, your one and only VASU, and we are painting another cool painting. All right, for the colors I have chosen white, red, yellow, black, royal blue, and this new color, yellow ochre. It's a mix in between an orange or a yellow. Brown. I'm going to apply this yellow ochre color first to begin with. All right, so I'll give myself a little like a line as per the example that I showed you in the beginning when I start the video. If you remember, it has a little landscape. All right, so after that, I'm gonna just extend this yellow ochre color with the help of water, a little bit above that previous stroke that I did. Okay, and then I'll make sure that I'll fade this paint into the whiteness of the canvas itself. Okay, you start dark and then you fade it all the way towards that angle. All right, after that, I'm gonna just let it dry, air dry for a few minutes. I'm gonna create a light blue color, like a sky blue. So I'm adding a little bit of blue into my white and get this little sky blue color, this royal blue into the white, I mean. And then I'm gonna go with that blue on the other corner. Apply some blue from that very area. I'm gonna dry out my brush. I clean it up, dry it out. And then I'm going to use the dry brush and fade that orange into the blue. All right, disclaimer. All right, in the first step, when you're applying the orange, make sure that you apply the paint only once and then try to fade it into the lightness of the canvas. Then only it'll be easier for you to fade the blue into the into this orange or the ochre. So I have a blow dryer, so I'm gonna dry it like for 5 minutes, not more than that. So after drying a little bit, I'm gonna again use that big brush. Yellow, just yellow. And then I'm gonna apply yellow from the left hand side of the painting. Go back and forth. And I might need a little bit of white. Okay, so I'm gonna add a little bit of white into my yellow. And sort of blend that towards the left of the sky. This will be land, by the way, guys. So just to let you know. So I'm adding a little bit of white and yellow together from the left corner, left side. Now I'm gonna take some more of the yellow ochre and extend that from the top right corner. I'm gonna take that yellow ochre take some red and yellow ochre, and little bit, tad bit of black. So I'm grabbing it from the corner tip of my brush and just adding into the mix. And it's sort of now a brown. So I'm gonna apply that from the very end here and then extend that. Okay, I think this is enough, guys. So I don't wanna overdo it. Just a little bit of space I'm gonna utilize to add this brown. Then I'm gonna clean off my brush. Use a paper towel to wipe your brush off. And then with the dry brush, same big brush, we haven't changed the brush size at all. I'm going to feather or fade that brown into everything else above. All right, guys, now I'm gonna explain you how to do the clouds for our landscape and the sky. For that, I'm gonna add a little bit of white into my brown. All that white, I'm gonna add it into the brown first, some yellow. And then right in that area where I added that ochre onto the blue, I'm going to swirl, dab. Well, I would dab. It's easier to control that way. Haven't mentioned the brush size, guys. It's medium brush I'm using. I sometimes get like zoned out and I forget calling out the supplies. I'm getting used to the videos, as we all can see, learning as we go. I'm gonna add a little bit of dark area towards my clouds. This area underneath this big guy, and do some yellow, and then right after yellow, that yellow, the ochre. Can add a little bit of black inside of that cloud and spread it. Some more white and brown, that old color that we had. I'll go back to it and I'll add more dabs to translate more clouds in the sky, like little scattered ones. back to that darker shade. It's basically that brown mixed with some white and black. If you can't see this color. And I'll add these little dabs to show some distant, darker clouds. And I'm using this time my brush more flat. Like sometimes I'm using more sideways to create more fluff, and sometimes I just use it more flat, depending on what type of cloud I'm trying to create. I'll do some light areas on these guys too. I'm gonna add a little circle right here with white and small brush. Okay. Then I'm gonna clean up my medium brush, rinse it off, wipe it with paper towel, and then wipe it around that circle. Creates a little light effect, and I go back to the circle again and add another circle. Now this time I'm going to dry. All right, after some blow dry, I'm gonna go back to clean, dry, medium brush and just go over that circle one more time. All right, and spread that white. And then after that, I'm gonna take some yellow and then layer yellow over it. Fill in that circle with white. Shoot. I'm adding a little bit of black into my previous color. Then after this, we are ready for the camels and the land. So what I'm gonna do, I'll use medium brush, black, and go straight, slopey stroke with a medium brush and black, and you make a stroke all the way across, slant it down, and fill it inside underneath that stroke, all black. Guys, I'm gonna paint some camels and people here. I will also have the stencil for that that you can copy if that makes it easy for you to get it done. I will have it in the description under the before the comments and the link for it. So here we go. I'm using smallest brush, black, and for the camel, I will start off with the neck first. So above the ground, I'm gonna start off with a curvy line first. We're gonna start with stick figure first, a line like that. We all can see it. I will also edit a close-up version next to it in the video. Right, a stroke like that. And then camel has a body to it. So for the body, we're gonna add a line like this, right? And a triangle first over it, like that. And then slant it down like that. All right. Then after that, we're going to box it up and then add legs. So one line, front leg, it's like an L shape, and then another straight line behind it. And then now I'm gonna add more character to this skeleton of camel. So now you gotta follow my lead. I'm gonna show you guys and move my hand. Now I'm making another one partial here. So follow my lead. The same steps that I have done for here. Now for the human being, I will start with a little head, a body, hips, and legs. Okay, stick figures first. We got arms here, right? And now I'm gonna add more volume to his body. He's wearing pants. He's wearing like desert attire, some drapery. All right guys, this is the painting. Now, please subscribe, press that notification icon to know that what's the latest painting that I'm trying to share with you guys. And also like if you had good time watching this painting or learning something out of it. Also leave a comment too, so I can improve as I go. I'm trying to, like, you know, create more videos and share some new techniques and break it down as much as possible. So hope to see you guys again. Sayonara.